You know, a mite of money goes a mickle bit in this city. Think of the power of good you can do with the purse you bring. You talk of a store in London. Well, now's your chance. That there map shows who to speak to. Old friends, if you will. Give him a whiff of that sterling, and maybe you can save us all from having to lay down our knife and fork afore we're ready. Now, enough shop talk. Believe Mr. Green said there was someone he wanted you to meet. Oh.
Oh, blast them.
Alec, whatever is the matter?
I have been intercepting nothing but poppycock propaganda about soothing syrup and whatnot. No, I swear to high heavens, if Starrick's monopoly continues...
Alec, I beg your pardon. These are friends of mine. Evie Frye and her brother, Jacob.
Alexander Graham Bell.
Linguist, inventor, and technical expert. Alec, I have something of a favor to ask you.
Can you fix this?
Oh, looks like the casing is cracked. Oh, comes apart. I see. Could have used one of these to fit my fuses on top of Big Ben.
Alec is installing a new telegraph line for our Free Press Association.
To combat the Static Telegraph Company. Now, if I can mend the fuses connecting independent lines from Big Ben, Static will be weakened. Only, we are somewhat at a handicap. And, there. Oh, I've removed the mechanism, so it may work with your bracer.
I'll put it to use immediately.
Jacob, wait. Mr. Bell, allow me to help you with your fuses.
Oh, you will not find me too proud to accept Miss Frye. We can use my carriage, if you'd be so good as to hold the reins, though.
I'll take that.
I can help you.
Miss Frye, I am so glad you could assist me. You really ought to be here by now.
So, Mr. Bell, what inventions are you concocting?
I intend to develop a phonetic telegraph that does not just convey dots and dashes, Miss Frye, but a human voice.
Phonetic telegraph? Sounds a bit of a mouthful. You could just call it a telephone.
Telephone? How bizarre. Anyway, as I was saying earlier, the press has become entirely dependent on the Static Telegraph Company.
Which is why Mr. Green has asked you to set up a free line.
Yes. What is more, other small independent companies have had their lines sabotaged, and they have little means of finding any broken fuses, which are...
to be found on top of Big Ben.
Correct. Especially as one needs a special government pass to get through the guards.
They will not be a problem. I'll repair the fuses. Slowly now. Lovely view.
All set. Should do it.
Thank you very much, Miss Frye. I will now be able to continue with the installation of the new line.
If there's anything else I can do to help...
Certainly. Please do come and visit. I was toying with this device and have noted down the formula for you. It's not perfect yet, but by golly, it works.
Don't be such a stupid thing! Freya! slice you open! Now, catch it!
Ah, Miss Frye!
I was just showing Jacob the first message was received via the mended lines. Oh, you can keep the rope launcher, by the way. We've managed to procure another one for your brother. Excellent work. Thank you, again.
You're very welcome, Mr. Bell.
We can now defend the principle of impartial news and free speech.
Free is fair, but free and brief is far better.
Ha ha! Ah, Frye, such caustic wit.
And on that note, we must depart.
Good fortune to you both. Call on me at any time.
Now that we've finished with that distraction...
Who is that? Oh, you mean you don't know?
Beautiful train you got here. Miss McBean was just telling me all about her. Name's Ned.
How do you do?
I won't take up more of your time. If you want to learn a thing or two about the finest transit systems in the world, you can find me at this address.
Let us return to locating the Peace of Eden.
We need to reclaim London from Starrick. Who are my targets?
It's not time for that yet.
I didn't come to London to hunt Cheerios.
First understand the dance, only then become the dancer.
Oh, so you're taking over where Father left off.
Someone has to.
Evie, finding the precursor artifact will give us an insight into what the Templars intend. Jacob, I have information about Starrick's associates that should be of use to you. Here. This soothing syrup has become the only medicine available in Lambeth. It bears the Templar Grandmaster's name.
About time for a visit to the doctor.
I don't see that cure arriving anytime soon.
And what exactly will you be doing, might I ask?
You know very well. Tracking down the Peace of Eden.
Enjoy your studies. I'll be out killing Templars.
Expecting a fist fight, dear brother. The train's ours now. May as well make ourselves at home.
Frye, a pleasure to see you.
Lunch for me.
Perpendicular, I suspect.
Careful with that blade, oh brother of mine.
The glint of your brass knuckles really brings out your eyes. Fetching outfit, I must say.
I need a wee bit of advice. These past few days when I've been doing my round, some bump what starts falling. Nervous looking lad. He's up to no good.
Tell you what, do your rounds as usual. If he appears, I'll keep an eye on him. When we return, put him into the train.
Aye, all right.
Agnes. Take care, there's a gang out looking for you.
all. Just one glacket laddie following me.
You certain?
Certain as can be.
These streets aren't safe at night. My ma sort of...
There he is, the rascal.
Hold on, stupid nag!
Are you hiding from someone?
Watch where your daddy coming.
I'm so sorry, miss.
That's missus to you, you great oaf.
Woman's from an important gang.
Gang? What gang's that?
I think it's in a train!
Sounds like the bastards will be okay, lot. Alert the lads on the rooftops. We'll take her out.
To get you.
No, some idiot can't even follow me proper.
No, they're dangerous. There might be an ambush in the station.
Tinny be daft.
I must get to the station before Agnes does. Who's following Agnes.
Who are you?
Nigel Bumble.
Why were you following us?
I want to join your gang.
Ah, for Christ's sake, he knows who we are now. All right, laddie. I can use you to tidy up the train a bit, if you didn't mind getting dirty.
Really? Terrific! You won't regret it, miss.
Soothing syrup is made from the finest ingredients, imported from all the corners of the Empire and beyond. Get Staric's soothing syrup right here!
It's all he drinks. Your syrup is liquefying him. He's turning him simple-headed.
Now, look now. You are scaring away my customers. Why don't you bugger off or I'll give you something to remember me by.
You can't talk to me like that, you little gutterling.
What's all this then?
Oh, sod off!
If you'll excuse me, madam. Tell me where the syrup originates.
All I know is they make a run each day between the gasometers and the asylum.
Doing fine, girl. In charge of the syrup distribution runs a fighting club at the foundry.
Syrup, mate. Speak now or forever hold your...
The distillery. It's the large building beside the brewery.
Now, to stop soothing syrup production once and for all.
Gracious. Never in my life. Maybe it would be better if I went home.
Sharp eye out, lads. Someone's targeting our network. The distillery might be next.
This will complicate things. You should not go about frightening respectable gentlemen, young man.
I didn't realize snooping around was considered gentlemanly.
Snooping? Sir, I assure you.
Keep vigilant.
Quick, inside. That was too close a call. You, young man, gave me quite a fright. I thought you were one of them. But I realize now why you're here. Same reason I am, I imagine.
I imagine?
You should see this.
Rather impressive contraption, wouldn't you say?
I've seen bigger.
Datura stramonium. Devil's snare, as it is commonly called.
That goes into the syrup. An opium, no less.
Revolting. Absolutely sickening.
A favorable way to proceed, wouldn't you agree? Find a way out of here, quickly!
What about the other valves?
Take a wild guess.
Very well, Captain.
Thank you.
someone!
Someone there!
Shot by express bastard!
Well done, dear boy.
Well done.
Charles Darwin, delighted to make your acquaintance.
Jacob Frye, the pleasure's all mine.
While you were busy wreaking havoc, I found this. It indicates that a sample of every batch has been sent to Lambeth Asylum.
I wonder if it's visiting hours.
Don't be so hasty, Mr. Frye. Many people work at Lambeth. You wouldn't want to attract unwanted attention.
Mm. What was the fun in that?
Not every problem can be solved by blowing things sky high. Sometimes a little discretion is in order. It's getting late. I will meet you at the asylum to continue our investigation.
I may not agree, but I have never done you wrong, sir. Never, I say.
Mr. Owen, you are truly the most insufferable fellow I have ever had the misfortune to count among my acquaintances. Mr. Dickens was right. Foul weather wouldn't know where to have you.
Foul weather? Bah! I have always been convinced that existing influences were responsible for the ordained birth of species. Let me remind you, sir, that you have accused me of abusing science, yet you... I'm making my very ears bleed!
You wound me, sir! Will you, Mr. Owen, for once in your miserable life, tell the truth and admit your guilt in this matter?
There's a murderer here! I have told you before, sir, I had nothing to do with that anonymous article. Nothing, I say.
That is a lie, sir. And you know it.
Bah, I don't have time for this nonsense.
Nonsense? It is my name and reputation you have willfully besmirched, sir. My very name.
Bah! Drive, damn you, drive!
That is Richard Owen! A vile, despicable wretch of a man!
Really? I could have sworn you were close friends.
Mr. Owen works at the asylum. He will know who made the syrup. Get him!
Get him!
None at all?
But if you're trying to intimidate me, ruffian, you're wasting your time.
I've always wondered how much of a beating this type of vehicle could take. I just have a few questions for you, sir.
Whatever it is Darwin wants, I will not give in.
Ah!
soothing syrup.
Soothing syrup? Why would a scientist have any interest in panaceas?
I wager your life, Mr. Owen, that you know something.
No, I'm telling you, I do not know a thing. I swear, nor am I involved, nor have I ever been involved with anyone selling that fake medicine.
There may be some truth to that, but you do know who created it. Tell me!
I will not utter a word on the matter. I am a gentleman, sir, and I...
Next stop, the River Thames. Better speak now, old man. Next stop, the River Thames. Better speak now, old man.
Stop! For pity's sake, stop, or I will tell you everything I know.
Slow down now.
Steady on.
Easy does it.
Dr. Elliotson, Dr. John Elliotson, he's formulated the elixir. He's the man you want, not me. I beg you, good sir, stop these madness.
Now, was that so hard?
Yes.
Jacob, Miss Frye, how good to see you. Oh, have you seen Starlick's latest lies?
Lies in a newspaper?
What transpired from the new line you're establishing?
Oh, the cables we ordered never arrived. And then we intercepted this. A message mentioning cargo seized at College Wharf.
Then let's unseize it.
Oh, wait. Another intercepted wire contained the recipe for a powerful hallucinogenic serum. I've adapted this dart mechanism to work with your bracers.
Alec, you're a genius.
Well, that patently is untrue. Although I've also discovered that the serum adopts a form of a gas when subjected to heat.
Just when I think you can't surpass yourself.
See your cables get delivered. They've got themselves a new destination.
Let him breathe!
Poison. Val must know what kind.
Careful there, Mr. Bell.
Every worthwhile endeavor is fraught with dangers, my dear friends. None more so than yours. But you have triumphed once again.
How do you know?
We have entered the age of communication, remember? We've already received word from Greenwich that the shipment has arrived safely, thanks to you.
Have you discovered what else is in that shipment?
Indeed. I'm afraid that Starek's poison has found its way onto the open market.
If he believes that will stop us, he is mistaken.
I knew you'd show. My warmest welcome. It's our business to keep London in balance, monitoring shipments by road, sea, and rail. Our biggest problem, the blighters. If you could rid us of them, I'd be ever so grateful.
It would make London safer.
You find anything that sparkles, it's yours.
I do love a bit of sparkle.
Thank you.
That's it. Easy now.
Be quiet. I said, be quiet.
I'm in the middle of work.
Is it your job to pollute the river?
It's nothing personal, but a man must also make a living.
A man must pay for his crimes. Need a peep from
what's
you.
All the ruckus,
help! Desmond, come quick! Someone's been killed!
I'm trapped! Get me out of here!
Someone's been killed!
Send one of the medical staff down to assess the damage.